The Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and the angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him a throne, the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Dear siblings in Christ, grace to you and peace from God, the Creator of all, from Jesus, whose birth we celebrate today, and from the Holy Spirit, who brings it all together. Amen. Well, this morning, when most Christians are getting ready for tonight, we are here and we get a sneak peek into that window before the birth of Christ. And speaking of windows, I know you all don't get to see them very often, but that back window, of course, Christ is in the center of the window, and the Lamb at the top and the angels at the bottom. But on the left is the Archangel Michael with the scale of justice and the flaming sword of truth. And on the right, the angel Gabriel, the messenger, the one who brings good news from God, the one who comes and starts with the words, "Fear not." Since I've come to this church, I have loved this window so. It's so rich with the vivid jewel tone colors. But I sense the protection of the characters, all the characters in that window. And I wonder at the artist's choices of Michael and Gabriel. So this morning we get a sneak peek into that conversation that Gabriel had with Mary. "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." Or if you grew up Catholic, "Hail Mary, full of grace." The Lord is with you. And that is the meaning of Emmanuel right there. God with us. The Lord is with you. And then Gabriel story of how it's going to happen. Now, for all of these centuries, Christians have made a big deal of the miracle of Mary, the Virgin, having this baby without a man. Today, I want to focus on the fact that God chose this woman, a regular human being, to bear the Son of God. I mean, God can make people out of clay. We've all read Genesis. But God chose not only an ordinary woman, but an unmarried one. Oh, she was engaged, yes. But this birth, and to accept this role, was scandalous beyond belief. In that culture, Joseph could have had her stoned if he knew that he was not the father. In that culture, bearing a child as an unwed mother would have been scandalous for Mary and for Joseph and for Jesus. To accept that role would be to accept almost certain rejection. In fact, children of an unmarried mother were a despised caste. We don't have castes in our society, and yet, you know, we kind of do. The child of an unwed mother would have been lower than a slave, and only above a Samaritan. So when Jesus tells stories about Samaritans, he's telling stories about the cast-offs, the cast-outs, the I don't belong in this story people. And we hear it so often that we have associated them with goodness. I heard it on TV when someone came to the rescue in a terrible situation, and the newscasters called them a good Samaritan. Because that's culturally what we think of. But the Samaritan was despised. The child of an unwed mother would have been despised. And tonight we will celebrate the infant holy, as we ought. But this morning, I want to point out who God chooses to bear Christ. You see, in the Old Testament, starting in Exodus, when God had them build the Ark of the Covenant, wherever the ark went, the people believed, that's where God went. And as John read this morning, when David was finally established as a king, David wanted to honor God. David said, I have a house built of cedar. Now, if you've ever been in the Middle East, cedar is not easy to come by. I have a house built of cedar, God. I want build a house for you. Because I'm the king. And God said, nope. You are not going to build a house for me. God said, I'm going to build a house for you. And that house would be the culmination of the promises made to Abraham and Sarah. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the people of Israel have always remembered. If you read the Old Testament, it's always the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of the generations. And Jesus was in that lineage. The lineage of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and their wives. And also of King David. But when God decided where to announce God's presence on earth, the king didn't have any input into the who, what, when, or how. It wasn't going to come from powerful people. It was going to come from a lowly woman. We get little hints throughout Scripture, like when Mary and Joseph brought the baby Jesus to be dedicated to God, their offering was that of peasants, two turtle doves. That was the offering of someone who was poor. So Joseph did accept Mary, but God chose Mary, standing on Mary's own two feet. And to bear the Son of God was not going to be an easy task. Mary would endure much because of this child. But God sought her out. As God seeks us out to be bearers of Christ, to be bearers of Emmanuel, because God is with us, Emmanuel, God with us. And so we are also bearers of that light. Society scares people into conformity. But to be a bearer of God's light is to be a nonconformist. It's to live in hope. Hope that in the end, God's got all the answers and love will win. Those four words you see floating around during Advent, hope, joy. We choose to live in the joy of Christ, the joy of the certainty of faith. And those two words seem like an oxymoron, but they're not. Not for God bearers. There is certainty in faith. Peace be with you is the greeting of the risen Christ. The opposite of fear. Fear not, says Gabriel. Peace be with you. When there is so little peace around the world, peace is not the absence of conflict. Peace is living congruent to the values of God and love. God is love. We sing love came down at Christmas. It's so subversive in this crazy world to live in hope, love, peace, and joy. But that's where God is. God with us. No less than Mary. As you celebrate the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, this morning it's still Advent. And so we pray, come, come, Lord Jesus. Come, be with us. Be Emmanuel in us. Break us open to be light bearers, to be Christ bearers in a cold world that needs that light, that love. Come, Lord Jesus. Be with us, that the peace of God.